Okay, so our base mesh is looking great. The silhouette is reading well. The details we've included are also reading well. At this point, I'm not going to add any more detail than what we've already got here. We've got enough to work with. We'll add more details or more subdivisions if we really need to. But as I said before, if you can get a good silhouette with the least amount of polygons, then you're on the right track. We'll leave it as it is for now, and then we'll make any additional changes later. So next stage is we're going to create some secondary mesh, and this secondary mesh will come in the form of this cloth that's going to be draped over the back of his torso right here. We'll also create the pants, the torn pants. Now when you're creating cloth, you should keep in mind that we need to give this a lot more resolution than what we have here. Okay, so cloth that has only this number of divisions is probably not going to be enough. It might be for certain computer games, but if we're going to get the cloth simulated properly, we need to have more divisions than, well, generally we'll have twice the amount that we've got here. So what we're going to do is select the faces from our base mesh and extrude some extra faces or duplicate some faces and then extrude them out to create the general shape of those pants right there, and we'll do the same with that. So very simple, just select your base mesh. I'm going to select the faces right here, and I'm going to go duplicate face. Now the other side has disappeared, that's because it's an instance. That's okay, it's normal, but the face is right there. Okay, so it's just basically what you've selected, it will copy it and then duplicate those specific faces for your needs. So this will be a separate mesh by itself. Okay, I'm just going to mirror duplicate those segments that have disappeared, do the same for that. And as always, I'm going to just continue extruding the edges down and getting a general shape of those cloth there. It's okay if you don't get it very accurately at first, because this is just cloth. But for now, what we need to do is just get a general idea or just a general silhouette of that object. Okay, one reason why I am extending that cloth in the back there a little bit more than usual is because when we're going to simulate this, we need it to have a lot of nice folds, okay, based on that. So as a result, I need to widen this substantially just so that we can get that simulation right. It's a little bit hard to teach you that at this point. It's much easier if I show you, so I promise you we'll definitely go through that when we get to the cloth sim stage. But for now, when you're creating cloth, especially when it comes to the back of the cape, always, always have it a little bit wider than usual, okay? So that we get nice deformations and cloth folds when we get to that stage. So while this time lapse is going, I do need to point out one other thing. When you're creating your cloth, especially these segments here, try to stay loose, because physics is a strange thing. You will need to make a lot of tweaks as you go when you're creating the simulation, when it's actually solving it, and there will often be problems that will come up that you won't actually foresee until you get to that solving stage. So don't lock your cloth off as 100%. Try and stay a little bit loose so that you can make those mesh changes. It's not like a skin bind. Cloth is a little bit more forgiving, but at the same time, it's definitely not as predictable. So that's our cloth surface so far. Now, obviously, the entire cloth is not actually completed and looks a little bit more of a Batman suit than anything, but that's okay. What we need to do is use the cloth sim to try and adjust this as we go. Like I said before, we need more resolution than usual. Since this is a simulation, it needs more resolution to work with, otherwise you're going to have very inaccurate deformations, especially when it comes to interacting with the body whenever it moves and such. So we need to make sure we've added those extras. One other thing I'm going to do is add one more piece of cloth that comes out from the knot here. This will be a very, very simple thing to do. So there you have it, guys. The cloth mesh for our low poly character is complete. We're going to leave it there for now and move on to the next stage of this modeling process.